Two brothers, one town, many possibilities.
I'm gonna be seeing other people. Is that what we're doing now?
Relationships are splitting.
What makes you think you're responsible for their marriage?
And emotions are raging.
We're supposed to want the people in your life to be happy. You should be together.
And now, an all-new Hyperion Bay. Previously on Hyperion Bay.
It's Dennis Sweeney from high school.
Oh, Nick's kid brother.
You're the son in Sweeney and Son, not me. Because I stayed and worked. Stop it, the brother!
I'm his girlfriend. Not till he says so.
You shouldn't have to help me pack for this, Amy. I'm the one who's leaving. Sorry about you and Nick.
Me too.
I thought we were sharing the responsibility.
But it's still my company, okay?
Sure.
I know you don't understand, but this is something I have to do for me. Divorcement, I'll have a real say in the company. Some respect, some responsibility. And in my opinion, you will actually count for something, not like here. I'm telling you, I'll finally be a free man.
Welcome aboard, son.
Thanks.
Here.
A pager?
Yeah. Wurtzman's got to know where you are if he's going to yank your chain.
Yeah, of course.
Well, I bet you're kind of anxious to get started, huh?
Yes, I am.
Wurtzman wants this delivered today. First thing.
Oh, where to?
Mr. Dennis Sweeney. He's the head guy over at Muse Prime. I guess I don't have to tell you where that is.
Cuban Upmans.
This is some gift. You know, the day before the embargo, JFK sent Pierre Salinger scouring D.C. for them.
Well, I guess you're supposed to be impressed then.
Come on, say hello to Dad.
Is that you?
Yep.
Oh, guess Wurtzman doesn't want to lose you.
No, I mean, I don't mind, really. I mean, it's pretty standard these days. Do you have a phone that I can use anywhere?
Oh, sure. Any desk. 9 to dial out. Come back when you're finished.
Right.
Yeah, hi, it's me, Nick. Sweeney. Yeah. No, I'm coming straight back. Yep. Right, bye.
Hey, you, buddy. You're destroying my whole setup here.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't see. Here, let me help you.
Let go. Come on. I'm fine. I said I was fine.
All right. Well, you didn't look fine.
Yeah, well, I've been waiting for 3 days. Three for some inept tech support dweeb to hook me up to the satellite line. These 56.6 BPS downloads are killing me.
Well, yeah, I can see how a thing like that could bother a person.
Is that your usual voice?
Yeah, I think so.
No bad colds recently? Haven't been up all night smoking or drinking?
No, not that I'm aware of.
Interesting.
Okay, well, you seem fine. I'm just,
do you have the floppy? Thanks, I'll take a look. Hey, Dad, check these out. Cuban Upmans. You got a whole box.
Ken Wurtzman. He's big with gifts. Likes you to know how much money he's got just to throw around.
Hi, Dad.
Hey, Nick.
Look, Dennis, I gotta go. Do you want to give Wurtzman a message, anything?
Thanks for the cigars, I guess.
This conveyor track. You want it taken out, right?
No. That's something different in the mix. I want it.
It's a piece of junk. You got people eating in here. You don't want them looking at this.
Are you kidding? My people like this kind of junk.
Let me tell you why you don't want this. First of all, it's filthy dirt. You don't want people eating with this kind of dirt in here. It's got rust all over it. It's going to get all over this food.
Hey, will you say something for me into this?
I really can't. I'm in a hurry.
Thanks. That was great.
When you see a guy reach for stars in the sky, you can bet that he's doing it for some doll.
You are in fine voice, Rudy.
Rehearsal time is key to a good performance. Also, it helps you remember your lines better.
Can I have a small coffee, please?
Sure, you don't want a nice cappuccino? How about a latte? Non-fat with a hint of cinnamon?
Sorry.
Ice blended mocha. I got that too.
Just a small coffee, black.
Band of Buzz, make that a brunette. Those cannery guys, they love that crap. Amy.
Brian.
Hi.
Hi.
Here you go, Sister Sarah.
Thanks.
I called, you know, a couple times.
Sorry I didn't get back to you. I was going to,
well,
but,
this is better anyway. Now I can ask in person. There's this show at the high school auditorium.
Oh, yeah, Guys and Dolls. I know. It's Rudy's first starring role.
Anyway, I put an ad in the program for my store, and they sent me these two tickets. I was wondering, would you want to go?
Brian?
It could be fun.
You have to understand.
Forget what I said about fun. We wouldn't have any fun, I promise.
I don't know.
And anyway, it's community theater. How could that ever be considered an official date? I mean, they're not even professional actors.
You're not giving up.
I gave up once.
Okay. But at intermission, I buy my own lemonade.
Brownies and wine. What kind of combination is that? One's a dessert.
No, I can't believe I let you drag me to this.
Trudy dragged me. I had to drag somebody.
I think it's probably the best production of Guys and Dolls I've ever seen.
I love community theater. My friend Paul and I used to go all the time. We once saw a 6-hour production of MAME. I'm going to put our names on the mailing list.
You should have been Adelaide, huh? It's criminal you didn't get that part.
I think I act better than Lynn Prager. I think I sing better, too.
Well, I don't know about that, but you sure have done a better job filling out those costumes.
Don't tell Rudy, but I think the movie's better.
I never saw it.
No, we could rent it.
And watch it together?
Well, I suppose we could take turns, but then we'd have to rent it for 2 nights. If we watch it together, we save $2.
Well, then let's do that.
You mean like a date?
No, not at all.
Glad we cleared that up.
How you doing?
Oh, I'm being entertained within an inch of my life.
You know, Amy's here, Brian.
No kidding, I didn't notice.
I'm just saying.
No, just don't say anything.
Oh, on Saturday night, jeez.
Yeah, you better set that to vibrate. You don't want to beep in during the show.
How much more of this torture have we got?
An entire second act.
Well, I better go see what this is about.
Amy.
Hi.
Hi. Hi, Nick.
Hi, Brian.
Well, the show's going well. Everybody seems to be having a good time. On stage, I mean.
Yeah, I guess. I mean, musicals don't do much for me, remember?
Yeah, I seem to recall you having a hard time imagining that anybody would be so happy they'd just start singing about it.
Well, it just doesn't seem natural to me.
Well, maybe you take it too seriously.
Yeah, maybe I do.
So how are you?
Okay. You?
Okay.
Good.
Second act.
Yeah, we should get back.
Yeah. Yeah, you don't want to miss what comes next. Well, I guess I'll see you.
Was that rude guy the other day?
That was my rude brother, Nick.
Distinctive voice, very resonant. What if I wanted to sample Nick some more? How do I make that happen?
Well, I'm a close relative. Can't you just use me?
No, you have way too many filters.
Filters?
So where would I find Nick, like, right about now?
He usually has lunch at Parsons. Oh, but Nick is not a person who likes to talk much.
Oh, yeah, good. I like a challenge.
Yeah, I thought you might see it my way. All right. Yeah, talk to you later. Bye-bye.
I gotta stop eating so fast. Look, there's almost nothing left of this burger. I hardly remember more than a few bites. Maybe I should order another.
Hi. It's Nick, right? I'm Claire. We met the other day at the cannery, remember?
Oh, yeah, I remember.
I'm working on a special project, voice recognition software. The idea is you interact with your computer by talking to it. No keyboards, no mouse. I really like your voice for this project. It'd be a big help if I could listen to you some more.
Never thought about my voice much.
Well, I have. Any chance you could come around sometime and read a list of common words and phrases for me? I could make some recordings.
Come by the cannery, you mean? Just...
No, actually, I've got all the equipment I need at my motel.
Oh.
Consider it. I'll be around tonight if that works. 8 o'clock, room 134. It's the one that's dangerously close to the candy machine.
Boy, you are so lucky, man.
Wow, what?
No. No, Nelson, I can't.
What'd you forget? You must. You are a free man. You gotta go for it, buddy.
You know, there's something I'm gonna miss about staying at the motel. Passing the wet towels on the floor. The decadence. The squish under my feet.
Oh, so you don't see Jennifer running around the house cleaning up after you? Oh, well, congratulations, kiddo. Here's two sets of keys. You're cohabitating.
Wow, I guess I still don't see myself as someone women actually say yes to.
Which is part of your charm, I think.
You do? But when you say part, what exactly would the rest be?
Ooh, better you don't know. Trudy?
Hi. Are you okay? I mean, we didn't get a chance to talk the other night at the play. I mean, we were sort of with Nick and you were with Brian. We haven't really even spoken since you and Nick. How are you?
I'm getting more and more and more.
Okay. You and Brian look great together. My apologies to Nick, but it's true.
Oh, we went out, Brian and me, in high school, you know, before some things are meant to be.
I mean, I don't know what happened with you and Nick, but unless you want to tell me.
I'd really rather not get
okay,
into it.
I completely understand.
So you're not my neighbors bitching some more about the music?
No.
Because I've already turned it down twice. Well, it isn't pretty, but it's home. Ever hear feng shui?
Not exactly, no. I'm sorry.
It's the Japanese art of placing things in a room that will attract harmony and positive energy.
Huh. So what, you're telling me, you've studied this?
No, I think it's crap.
Oh.
Hey. So I guess we should get started, right?
Right. Yeah.
Okay, first, Here. I've got to ask you a few blah, 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 get to know the subject questions, okay?
Okay, shoot.
I didn't even thank you for doing this. That's really piggy of me.
Yes, it certainly is.
Cool that you showed up.
Well, I'm glad you asked.
Okay, so tell me, what is your full name?
Yes, James Nicholas Sweeney.
Sex?
Male.
Age? What is your age, Nick?
I can see your underwear. Just totally see your underwear right there. Mm.
Better?
Much, yes. And I'm 27.
Height and weight?
6'2", 185. You know, it's just a little...
Tropical, I know, sorry. I don't know why I bother. I'm convinced this thing isn't actually connected to anything. So what else did I need to ask you? Oh, yeah. Marital status.
Married. Separated.
So how about we start on that list of words and phrases now?
Yeah, okay.
All right, just speak in your natural voice at your natural speed and don't worry about volume.
Okay. Turn on. Turn on? Do you mean like,
You're talking to a computer.
Oh, no, of course. Turn on. Turn on. Turn on. Right, I got that.
Yeah.
Turn on.
Mm-hmm.
Now that's... Nathan Detroit.
You know, Rudy makes a great cup of coffee, but he is no Sinatra.
Who is?
More wine?
Okay, sure.
When you meet a mug lately out of the jug, and he's still lifting platinum balls.
So you enjoying the movie?
Mm-hmm.
Call it hell, call it heaven, it's a probable 12-7 that the guy's only doing it for the ball. When you see a sport and his cash has run short, you can bet that he's banking it with some doubt.
When a guy wears tails with the front gleaming white, who the hell do you think he's tickling pink on Saturday night? When a lazy slob takes a good steady job and he smells.
Feels like your parents are coming home any minute.
Yeah. Call it dumb, call it but they're not.
Up and you can give odds forever that the guy's already doing it for some dumb, some dumb, some dumb. The guy's only doing it for some dumb.
What if we didn't rush to fill this place up with furniture and stuff? It's kind of peaceful and orderly like this. It's minimal, clean. I like it. I think it could even help me think better.
If Nick and Amy start seeing other people, that could lead to something. And then where does that leave me? What the hell am I supposed to do?
My foot.
Excuse me?
My other foot.
I just don't want things to get so complicated that they can't, you know, get back together.
So somehow it's your job to fix this? What makes you think you're responsible for their marriage?
Well, because for now, the two of them are all caught up and obviously confused, and I'm not. I'm objective. Oh.
Stop obsessing. Cluttering up the house.
Do I seem filtered to you?
What's filtered?
Good. You don't know either.
That's it. Give me a wrench. We're pulling this thing out. Come on. Come on, give me a wrench now.
Control. Extend. Pulse. Pulsate.
I really like what I'm getting, Nick. Go on.
Undo. Display. Enlarge size of text. Insert graphic here.
Again?
Insert graphic here. Release.
Well, that's it.
Yeah. So what happens now?
I use it to train the software to recognize your specific voice quality and pronunciation.
Oh, so the computer will understand me.
Recognize the words and react, not understand like people do. Not like I understand you when you talk.
Well, if you've got everything, I guess I should just...
I guess.
Yeah, okay then. What? What is it?
Your jacket's vibrating.
Oh, my beeper. God, let me see. Good night, Claire. And, thank you.
No, really. Thank you. Right, Nick.
I'd like to see you again if...
I'd like that.
I'm a decent cook. How about dinner at my house?
It wouldn't be a date.
Of course not.
I need you so, baby. Don't need me.
must really be late.
I guess so. Sorry, I'm disturbing you.
No, I'm fine. Making progress, actually. What's up?
Oh, well, I came by to see Dennis about something, and, he was busy, so... Anyway. So this is my voice, huh? I'm not sure I like how it sounds.
Well, most people feel like that.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, Nick. Hi. Reception didn't even page me. How long have you been here?
Not long.
Actually, he's here to see me.
Oh, okay. Smartass.
Since early childhood.
Claire, research dug up the latest customer satisfaction survey for the IBM Via Voice. I need you to take a look at it, see where we stand.
Sure thing.
So anyway, Claire, you feel like taking a break? Maybe getting some coffee with me?
Yes, perfect timing.
Actually, Claire... I want you at that marketing meeting today. Those guys need your input on the project.
Oh. Well, we could have dinner.
When?
How's tonight?
Great. Great. How's 7? I'll pick you up at the motel.
Better make it here instead. I'll just be finishing up.
All right. Well, sounds like a plan. I'll see you at 7.
Yes, you will.
It was just like we were back in high school. I never thought I'd feel that way again.
My hairs are sticking up just hearing about that.
But I don't want anything more to happen. You know, I mean, like next time, if there is a next time.
It's about knowing when to stop before it gets too hot and heavy. That's the key.
When do you know to stop? What am I supposed to say? What am I supposed to do? I feel completely inept.
This is not you in particular, Amy. This is a side effect of being married.
Yeah.
You don't stop along the way at this point or that point when you're doing it with a husband. No. You start, you both seriously go at it, and then... he finishes. At least that's the way it's been in my experience.
I just wish that I could trust myself more.
What do you mean, trust yourself?
You know, like draw the line and seriously stick to it and not get carried away in the moment.
Some of the best things that have ever happened to me happened and I got carried away. You should try it sometime. Maybe you already have.
I gotta go.
What are you doing?
Beth.
The intelligent thing.
I told you that I wanted to keep it up. We talked about this.
Hold the work, everybody. Just a minute while we iron something out.
I want the conveyor back.
Son, listen.
It's all well and good to let your imagination run wild, but now the canteen's got to be built, and that's a job for a realist. Am I right?
I want it back.
It's already out.
Put it back. Today. Or I'll get someone who will.
Nick? Brian?
Excuse
us. That's a good wine. Special occasion?
Dinner.
With a friend. A friend. You know, we've lived in this town our whole lives, you and I, and I've never heard anyone say a word against you.
What is it you want, Nick?
I want you to be very careful. Because if anything bad happens to her, I'll know it. And I'll know who to look for. I'm not interested in hurting anybody, least of all, Amy.
That's good.
Because if you do anything but hurt her, or take advantage of her, well, I guess I just have to kill you. I mean that the nicest possible way, Brian.
Whether I shall turn out to be the hero of my own life or whether that station will be held by anybody else, these pages must show. To begin my life with the beginning of my life, I record that I was born, as I have been informed and believe, on a Friday at 12 o'clock at night. It was remarked that the clock began to strike and I began to cry simultaneously. 150 words a minute, Sweeney. We're getting there, damn it.
Excellent. I'm loving that.
Plus, I got our vocabulary up another 60,000 words.
Right.
Ooh, putting that shower in the ladies' room, that was a really thoughtful touch.
Claire, listen, I know we talked about getting your accuracy test results over to Borden later on in the week, but there's a lot of heat on this, and I'm going to need that work done tonight.
Oh. Do you have a problem with me going out with your brother?
What? No. No, of course not.
You're certain?
Yes.
Good. I just wanted to make sure because those test results are already done.
Oh, okay.
You hired me to do a job, and I do it. But what happens after I punch out is my business, right?
Right. Claire, don't do anything to make me sorry I hired you.
So much for my moment in the spotlight.
Well, there's always next season, Rudy.
Next season, you're doing Dreamgirls.
Hey.
Nick.
I was just trying one of Rudy's new coffee with chocolate in it type deals.
Supposed to be good.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. It is good. You want to try?
No, thanks.
Look, you and Brian Stewart, I know that...
We're starting to see each other, Nick.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, we're just starting to.
Is that what we're doing now? Gonna be seeing other people?
Well, I guess. Yeah?
Yeah. Seems to be where we are now.
It does.
Hey, Nick, this is great. This is perfect. Can I talk to you for a minute?
No, I can't.
No, I know. This would be quick, and really, now's the time.
Import that.
Claire's terrific. All right, she is. But you don't want to do anything that'll screw things up with Amy.
I don't.
No. No. I don't think you do. Anyways, this attraction to Claire, I'm sure it's only one of those, you know, rebound type feelings that start off wow and then they end up help, get me out of here, don't you think? I do.
Oh gosh, Pop, I hadn't seen it like that. Thanks for setting me straight. You know, Dennis, your heart to hearts are very nick at night.
I just try everything I can think of.
We'll drop it. Okay, you're starting to get on people's nerves. Besides, what the hell business is it of yours? I mean, this is between Amy and me. At least it was.
You and Amy. You and Amy, Nick, I remember it so different. It was the three of us for so long. It was you and Amy and me. At the house, on the boat, Saturdays, whole summers. She's the first girl that I ever really got to know. And it's not just the two of you breaking up. It's the three of us. I love you guys. And you should be together.
No, you like the idea of us being together. Well, so did I. But the idea wasn't enough, and we split. And I'm telling you, it hurts. And I feel lousy. And I imagine that she does, too. But you know what? It wasn't the end of the world. Just like it wasn't when I quit Dad. Look, Amy is seeing Brian. And I don't like that one bit, but there it is. I like Claire. And I don't know much more than that right now, but I like her. And I have a chance to get to know her, thanks to you. So I'm going to see what happens. Okay?
So what am I supposed to do? Just sit back and watch this?
No! No, you are supposed to want the people in your life to be happy. So you wish them well, and you hope that they figure out the best way to do it. For themselves. Not for you.
What are those?
Legs.
Now, you see, I knew they were legs. Recognized them right away.
You know, I never had a guy cook for me before. I feel like I should do something. Something helpful.
Taste.
Hmm.
What does it need?
Nothing.
See? You did something helpful.
I don't know if I should be here.
Do you, want to be here?
I think so, but I'm not sure.
Well, if you expect me to be noble and get your coat so you can leave, I have to disappoint you. I want you to stay.
Part of me, I feel like I'm taking advantage of you.
And I'm standing here asking you to do just that. What do you want, Amy? More important, what do you need?
I need the porch light to go out again. So I can stop thinking for 5 seconds.
My dad? My dad's a gambler.
You serious?
Yep. Every single vacation when I was a kid, we went to Las Vegas. And he tried to get me to go to Nevada for summer camp just so he could visit. College, he rode away to UNLV for brochures. He even told me more than once that if he hadn't married my mom, he would have been a blackjack dealer. That was his dream. And instead, he had to get a regular old straight job.
Which is?
He's a stockbroker.
Oh, well, no risk there, huh?
Absolutely none.
So tell me, are you your father's daughter?
Not with money, no. Hmm. But I do feel like I have good intuition, and I've been known to act on it.
Mm-hmm. Well, I guess intuition's all we've got to go on. You know, you'd think with a million years of evolution, we would have come up with something better by now. Still, just all comes down to taking chances, playing hunches. It's all still pretty new for me. So tell me, what was your dad's big secret? How does somebody become a good gambler?
Well, for starters, never bet more than you can afford to lose.
I guess it's just us on the night shift, huh?
Looks like it.
Listen, about today, the conveyor. I'm sorry. I guess I somehow...
Don't apologize for something someone else did wrong. I'm the one who screwed up. You were doing your job. Being the boss.
My father's boss. This is so complicated. I mean, you've been my dad for 25 years, and now I have to deal with Frank Sweeney. All of a sudden.
We're both going to have to figure something out. Some kind of new rules, I guess.
Too much new stuff is happening all at once, like with Nick. I'd hate like hell for him to get hurt or do something that he couldn't back out of.
I know.
So I tried to stop him, but that didn't work.
Well, I tried to keep him from signing on with Wurtzman by not stepping in the way, and that didn't work either.
So what are we supposed to do?
Honest to God, I have no idea.
How can you not know?
Give me a hand with it, okay?
Okay.
I know you want this, but can I show you how you can keep it, but it ends up in a better place?
Sure, I'll listen.
I was thinking, this big piece, the orbit, what if I moved it so it ends up next to the door?
It's only got a 4-inch hunk of plastic attached to it. You'd think I'd be able to find it. Here's.
Claire,
I like the way you say my name.
Is that a professional opinion?
Personal. Very.
Claire.
Your problem somewhere where there's light. No ghosts allowed tonight. No ghosts allowed.
Tonight's Hyperion Bay featured music from Hootie and the Blowfish, Deanna Kirk, and Allison Krause. Stay tuned for scenes from next week's episode of Hyperion Bay.